Well, hi everybody, this is Grace, and thank you for joining me. This is an addendum to the previous video for the Tea Cozy, and after I finished the Tea Cozy, I kept looking at the tag inside and deciding I did not like the way I had done it with a piece of paper across here to hide the ribbon. So what I decided to do is change it, and it has been changed in all the kits, and I wanted to make video to show that. So hopefully you'll watch this video first and then make the updated version. So what I did is I took a heavier piece of this is like tag board. It's about the weight of a cereal box, but so I made it the way I originally made the tag, before I changed it into a booklet, and then I added a booklet. Instead of trying to put them together, then I made them separate. Okay, and so anyway, got that, and so I'm going to show you how to do that real quick, okay? So we have the tag board here. Okay, and I'm going to use Vintage Photo to edge around this. You can use Walnut or Vintage Photo, whichever you prefer. I think I did use Walnut on that one. It goes faster because it's darker. But we'll get it done with this. Hopefully you can see it. I think I need to re-ink this pad. I'm going to take that out and remind myself. Where is it? Oh boy. Wild honey. Huh. Maybe I'll look for that in a little bit. It's in the back row, I guess. I really need to re-ink that. I'm gonna put the walnut. Working too hard. Let me get this covered soon. Good thing this paper is really, really stiff, huh? I'm tearing into it. Okay, that should do it. So then we'll just take a glue dot. I'm going to use a medium-sized glue dot, and I'm going to decide. Now, the important thing is you need to make sure that you get your decorations above the pocket. You don't want it to go into the pocket. So I'm going to stick that in there before I put my glue dot on. I'll just get it to the very end there, and then I'm going to put it down like right there. Okay? So now I know where it goes. I'm going to take this piece of twine. Let's see, how do I want to do this? Like this. Cross over that and wrap it around, going through the glue dot. And that way it stays in place while I do this. I'll just tie it in a knot right here and then push it into the glue dot. What happened there? Didn't do that quite right. I could have cut it a little bit longer and saved myself a little bit of work, but I'll get it. I just want a good strong knot that won't come undone. All right. I'm going to stretch these out a little bit. Like so. I think I'll put another glue dot on there too. Or put it on here. I'll just put it right on here. Okay, and then I'm going to stick that right on there. Now if you want to, you can put glossy accents under that and make sure that it's going to stay, which I can do right now. A lot of times I'll use glue dots to hold something in place and add glossy accents to make it permanent. Come on. There we go. Getting a lot of glue, glossy accents under that. That's such a good glue. Alright, so I got that. And so then I'm going to add the top part here. And you can ink around this, but this is so dark it doesn't really need to be inked. Try it anyway. And let's get that glued down. Like that. And then we'll take a hole punch. You can just use one of these, or you can use your crocodile. These are really handy to travel easy. Like that. And then you can take a piece of your twine that's left over, or the extra piece, and put it through there. Or just tie it on, whichever you want. I like to make a lark's head on there. I think that's what we used to call it in macrame. Okay, so there's that. Now I'm going to I do need some ink on this. Oh, my dogs are going crazy upstairs again. As usual. Somebody walks by and they go crazy. I think all dogs tend to do that. So I've got that. And I'm going to take a little pen before I glue this down. And I'm just going to draw a little line. And that. And glue it down. Goodness sakes. There's that. And then a red rhinestone. Now, if you don't have red rhinestones, there should be one in your kit. I'm sure there is. But if for some reason you want to make more of these, then you have clear rhinestones. You can always take a Copic marker and color your rhinestones. Okay, now the words. So, I just kind of want these random cut. I don't want them to look perfectly squared off. I just kind of deliberately kind of random cut them. There's peace. I just stamped these on my Misty on one piece so that they'd be all together and not be floating around your kit. Love, peace, love, and enjoy. And like I said in the other video, the enjoy was my sister's idea. She was here visiting from California, and So she has a way with words, so I really appreciate her doing that. So we'll make a little arrow pointing to the tea bags, the goodies, and put that down. Alright, so we've got our tag done. Now let's do our little booklet. You'll find in your kit a piece like this that is 5.5. And I cut it at 6.5 and then scored it at, did I cut it at 6.5? Yeah, 6.5. So that would be 3.25. This winds up being 3.25 across and 5.5 tall. And you'll have a piece of red in your kit. Yeah, I'll just use the glue. And it's cut 1/4 inch smaller around. So it's 5.25 by 3. And it goes on here with the border, like so. And then you can put a little snowflake on it. And I'll put mine in the corner. You can do that or in the center, whichever one you want. And that'll dry clear. And so, then you have, you have this and this. You can put a photo back here if you want. Tuck it right down in between the twine if you like. And move these wherever you want. And then you can put a photo here, or journaling, or you can journal and photo and photo. They have to be small, but still, you can cut them down. And then you just stick them into your booklet. And that will complete the edition for your little book. So I hope you enjoy it and finish the rest of the little tea cozy. All right, thanks. Bye.